Today we're going to have a nice partial fraction problems, you know. And we're going to discuss two cases today. The first one, when the denominator is the product of linear factors. As you can see, this denominator here is a product of x plus 3 and x plus 3. So this is the product of linear factors. So this is our problems. And we are asked to evaluate the partial fraction decomposition of this one. So, for our solution here, now, the first one, we are going to have two factors. Now, since this is two linear factors, we're going to have two factors of fractions. Now. So, the first one, a over x plus 3. And the other one, we just repeat and get the b over x plus 3 quantity squared. So we're going to multiply this whole equation by its LCD, you know, this common denominator, which is x plus 3 quantity squared. By doing that, we're going to get, we will cancel the denominator of the fraction on the left side of the equation. So what remains will be 2x plus 7 and a times quantity x plus 3, and the denominator of the second one is cancelled, no? So x plus 3 quantity squared will be cancelled because you're multiplying this whole equation by x plus 3 quantity squared. After that, now after having this result, no, we're going to set, no? To get a value b, we think of a number for x, so as to get rid of this first fraction here. So we set, no, x to be negative 3. So if we set x to be negative 3, this thing here will be cancelled out. What remains should be 2, no, setting x to be negative 3, 2 times negative 3 plus 7, and a will be 0. And b, you know, will be positive now. So 2 times negative 3 is negative 6 plus 7 is equal to b. So we're going to get the value b to be 7, no, minus 6. No. So our value for b is equal to 1. After which we're going to collect the constants, no, for the constants for this equation here. No. The constant on the left side is equal to 7, no? So the constant on the left side is 7, and the constant for a is 3, no? So 3a, the constant for b is 1b, no? So we're going to get 7 is equal to 3a plus b. So since we have found the value of b, no, we substitute b is equal to 1 to this equation here. So we're going to get 7 is equal to 3a plus 1. So 3a will be 7 minus 1 is equal to 6. So dividing both sides of the equation by 3, we get 6 over 3. So a will be 2. So we now have the values for a and b. No? A will be is equal to 2 and b is equal to 1. So we're going to just substitute these two values for our two decomposition of fractions. So a will be 2. So 2x plus 7 over x plus 3 quantity squared is equal to 2, which is the value of a over x plus 3 plus 1, which is the value of b, no, for this one. No. So 1 over x plus 3 quantity squared. So this will be our answer for problem number 1. For number 2, the case for number 2, the denominator has a distinct linear and quadratic factors. No? So we are given here this fraction here, 1 minus 13x minus 10x squared over x minus 2 over times quantity 2x squared plus 2x plus 1. As you can see, we have the linear and then this one is quadratic. No? So if this is the case, no, the resolution of this one would be this given problem here will be A over x minus 2 to the first denominator. And the second, since this is quadratic, now we just copy the denominator and we'll have this form, bx plus c over 2x squared plus 2x plus 1. So, knowing the LCD to be x minus 2 and 2x squared plus 2x plus 1, we multiply this whole equation by the LCD, these denominators. Upon multiplying, you get 1 minus 13x minus 10x squared is equal. So this one cancels out. What remains for A is the denominator of this second partial fraction, which is 2x squared plus 2x plus 1. And bx plus c will be multiplied by the denominator of this one. Since you cancel out this one, what remains is x minus 2. So we now have a different equation here. So as you can see by careful examination, we can get rid of this whole factors here by setting x is equal to 2. If we do that, setting x is equal to 2, so we substitute 2 to x. So what remains is 1 minus 13 times 2 minus 10 times quantity x of 2 quantity squared is equal to a, this a here. So 2x squared, since x is equal to 2, 2 squared is equal to 4 times 2 is equal to 8. 2 times 2 is 4, and plus 1, this constant here. So combining this left side equation, we get here. Here is here. 1 minus 13 times 2, which is 36, minus 4 times negative 10 is negative 40. Negative 40 plus negative 36 is 66, minus 1. Negative 66 plus 1 is equal to negative 65, is equal to adding these numbers here, 8 plus 4 plus 1 is 38. To get the value of A, we just divide both sides of the equation by 13, so negative 65 over 13 is equal to 5, negative 5. So, since we have found the value of A to be negative 5, now we're going to examine again the simplified form of our equation. First, we collect the coefficient of x squared. So, negative 10, this one is 2x squared, so 2a, and bx times x is plus b. So there's no coefficient for cx squared. So this one, so 2a plus b, So this will be our equation. Since we found the value of a to be negative 5, we just substitute a is equal to negative 5. We substitute a to be negative 5, so negative 10 is equal to 2 times negative 5, so is equal to b, 2, it's plus b, so this one is plus b, this one is plus b, so b, adding 10 to both sides of the equation, we get b is equal to 0. So now we have the value of a and b. Our a is negative 5 and b is equal to 0. We just substitute this to the simplified form of our partial fraction. So this one is a, which is, we substitute negative 5. So our final answer will be, we substitute a, to be negative 5, b is equal to 0, and we're going to get c is equal to, this is a negative 13, negative 13 plus 10. So c will be negative 3. So we now have of our three answers for A, B, and C. So we just substitute this in simplified form again. So this one is, this is our simplified form with our unknown A. A is equal to negative 5 and B is equal to 0. So we cancel out this one. And C is equal to negative 3. So negative 5 over x minus 2 minus 3, no? C is negative 3. Minus 3 over 2x squared, no? Plus 2x plus 1. So this will be our final answer. So it's a long process, but it's worthwhile because we're getting to get a good answer. So thank you again for watching our video. And please don't subscribe to my YouTube channel by Will Predictan. And click also that notification bell. Thank you. See you again later.